We got an issue in America. Too many good docs are getting out of business. Too many OBGYNs aren't able to practice their love with women all across this country.
Hi, this is Michael Moore, and as you probably have heard, I've got a new movie coming out on June 29th. It's called SiCKO, and it's about our American healthcare system.
Hi, so we're trying to project the trailer for SiCKO, Michael Moore's film SiCKO, which talks about the concerns about the healthcare system, and we want to project it onto the Kaiser building right there.
How long are you going to be out here?
As long as possible.
Is to maximize profits.
If you denied more people health care, you got a bonus.
When you don't spend money on somebody, it's a savings to the company.
I want America to have the finest health care in the world.
4 health care lobbyists for every member of Congress.
Here's what it costs to buy these men and this woman, this guy, and this guy.
And the United States slipped to 37 in health care around the world, just slightly ahead of Slovenia.
So if you would like to videotape your story and send it here, I'll post it, and YouTube will post it, and I'll also take these YouTube videos to our members of Congress.
Hi, my name is Quay, and I'm replying to Michael Moore.
Hi, my name is Sean Kent. I have a couple medical horror stories that I can share with you.
Hi, Mike. My story is that now I am recovering from a heart attack and triple bypass that I had a few months ago at the age of 42.
Okay, so I called these people at the clinic where I go to see my doctor.
I have asthma. I can't get inhalers. I have bipolar disorder. I can't get lithium. I sit here every day wondering, being afraid of getting sick, because I'm afraid of going to the hospital and getting a $1,000 charge for a high fever.
Starting in 2002, my appendix went out on me 3 days before the health insurance I was due to receive kicked in. Now, because I made enough money to not qualify for low income assistance, yet I didn't have health insurance, the hospital did what it always does in situations like that, which is try to make up money on their bottom line by sticking it to people like me.
And to make matters even worse, before the heart attack, I was diagnosed with fibromyalgia and was put on medical leave. And I thought I was one of the lucky ones because our office had disability insurance. But surprise, surprise, they denied my claim.
So for a procedure that normally would have been billed to an insurance company at anywhere from $5,000 to $7,000, they billed me for $30,000. This led to me eventually having to file bankruptcy. I actually saw a 60 Minutes special on this practice because apparently it's very prevalent, and they actually highlighted the exact hospital where I was treated, St. Joseph's in Burbank. Apparently they're very well known for this.
It's not like I don't make payments. And I ask her, well, why don't you fix your system? Because every time I walk through your doors for whatever, whether it's an emergency, whether it's for blood work, whether it's to see the doctor, whether it's for x-rays, whatever I go, it's a new account number. Okay. After a while, that shit starts to add up. So I've got, I think at last count, like 10 account numbers for these people. And you know, my husband doesn't make the kind of money to where I can give them $100 a month on 10 accounts.
I really resent that I was not just given my disability and that I had to basically lose $800 of it per month just to get the insurance company to do what they were supposed to and give me the claim that I had rightfully paid into. And you know, I've worked since I was 19 years old, and it just seems very strange that if you work really hard and once something goes wrong, you're just left out in the cold. And
I can't give them $50 a month on 10 accounts. I just can't do it, okay? I've got to buy my prescriptions. I've got to pay my, you know, we've got rent. We can't own a house because we don't have the credit or the savings to get a house because, you know why? We had to file bankruptcy because of fucking medical a few years ago.
This guy broke his ankle. How much will this cost him? He'll have some huge bill when he's done, right?
Yeah, NHS, everything is free.
I'm asking about hospital charges,
yeah.
And you're laughing. Even with insurance, there's bound to be a bill somewhere. What'd they charge you for that baby?
No. Everything's on
this is NHS. NHS.
Yeah, you know,
no,
it's not. It's not America.
So this is where people come to pay their bill when they're done staying in the hospital.
No, this is the NHS hospital, so you don't pay the bill.
Why does it say cashier here if people don't have to pay a bill?
Those who have reduced means get their travel expenses reimbursed.
So in British hospitals, instead of money going into the cashier's window, money comes out.
And Michael Moore is joining us now live from Detroit. Michael, thanks very much for coming in. You want to respond?
Well, first of all,
you want to respond to anything we just heard?
Yeah, I'd like about 10 minutes to respond to
give us a couple headlines, what you'd like to say.
I don't talk in sound bites, so that report was so biased. I can't imagine what pharmaceutical company ad's coming up right after our break here. But, you know, why don't you tell the truth to the American people? I mean, I wish that CNN and the other mainstream media would just for once tell the truth about what's going on in this country, whether it's with health care, I don't care what it is. I mean, you guys have such a poor track record. And for me to come on here and have to listen to that kind of crap, I mean, seriously, I haven't been on your show now for 3 years. The last time I was on, you'd ran a similar piece about Fahrenheit 9/11 saying, oh, this can't be true, what he's saying about the war, how it's going to be a quagmire, the weapons of mass destruction, you know. And why don't you start off, actually, with my first appearance back here on your show in 3 years, and maybe apologize to me for saying that 3 years ago, because it turned out everything I said in Fahrenheit was true. Everything's come to happen. Everything I said, I mean, I took you in that film to Walter Reed Hospital. And it took 3 years before you or any of the rest of the mainstream media would go to Walter Reed Hospital and see what was happening to our troops. So for me to have to sit here and listen again to more crap about socialized medicine or how the Canadians have it, you know, worse than us and all this, all the statistics show that we have a far worse health care than these other industrialized countries. We're the only ones that don't have it free and universal.
What kind of sick, cruel system is this? It's sick, isn't it? It's right. It's the real sicko, isn't it? There's no room for the concept of profit when it comes to taking care of people when they're sick. That question of how will this affect our bottom line, how will this affect our profits, that is an immoral question, and it should never be asked. There's no room for compromise here. There's no room for the health insurance company in an emergency room. There's no room for a health insurance company in a hospital room. There's no room for them in the executive headquarters of their own companies, because I believe that we have to eliminate the private health insurance companies from our health care system. We have to get rid of them once and for all. It's time for them to go. It's time for them to go. It's time for them to go.
Michael Moore's SiCKO.